Nicholas Spencer and Mackenzie Lane Spencer, who are facing charges of aggravated trafficking and torture of a 10-year-old boy, today appeared before the High Court Judge Isaac Mwata for the ruling of a bail application pending the hearing of the charges against them. In the ruling, Justice Mwata concurred with the defense lawyers that the accused persons cannot cope with the prison's condition, further releasing them on a cash bail of 50 million shillings each. Their sureties were each bonded 50 million shillings non-cash. The two were ordered to deposit all their passports and other travel documents to ensure that they do not flee the country. They are also supposed to report to the High Court at least once every month.
Shall deposit their passports with the court, and the applicants shall not travel outside this country without the express permission of court, and they shall report to the order that they shall report to Uganda Road, where the matter was being mentioned, but it seems now we are committed to where?
The international organization.
Yeah. So now the report to the registrar of the international crimes division.
The prosecution alleges that the couple between December 2020 and December 2022 at Naguru in Kampala recruited, transported and maintained a 10-year-old boy by means of a position of vulnerability for purposes of exploitation. It further alleges that the couple also committed an act of aggravated torture contrary to the Prevention and Prohibition of Torture Act of 2012 against the minor. The punishment upon conviction is life imprisonment. Meanwhile, the Anti-Corruption Court in Kololo has charged Fort Portal City Town Clerk Moses Otimong with 3 counts of abuse of office and causing the government a financial loss of over 1 billion shillings, to which he pleaded innocent. Upon his plea, Otimong, through his lawyers, applied for bail and presented 3 sureties, including Vincent Okrut, the town clerk of Masaka, and Paul Omoko, the town clerk of Mubende District. Presiding Magistrate Esther Simwe agreed to release him on a 5 million shillings cash bail. He returned to court on the 27th of April 2023. Still in court, over 200 residents of Bukasa Kirinya in Kira Municipality have petitioned court over their impending eviction from their land. They say they are in fear after receiving a 45-day eviction notice to vacate their land, which was gazetted by the government for the construction of a new inland port. They are now seeking orders to halt the government project until they are adequately compensated. The residents claim they had agreed to vacate the land on condition government compensates them adequately. However, according to valuation, they were paid between 900,000 shillings and 2 million, which is not enough to resettle them.
Okusasula abantu obusente.
Tuli ku pisto. Olucha lwetubala tuli nkoko ey'omutamivu. Aba Bukasa.
Saba. Abakulembeze bonna president tuyambe. Wagamba togenda kukomawo e Bukasa. Ogonyole ensonga zino. Aba. Tukusaba okomewo e Bukasa. Ogonyole ensonga kubanga bangi abezinzeemu muli munda muli. Aba. Gwe tomanyi ensonga lyatubatulugunyize eno emabega.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.